Hello everybody, we are still waiting for macOS Big Sur final release. Apple released Big Sur Developer Beta 10 yesterday, and probably it will be the last developer beta before the Gold Master version. If we look at the Catalina's release history, we can see that Catalina released 1 week later after the Beta 10. But since there are a lot of rumors about upcoming November event that probably includes ARM MacBooks with Apple Silicon, we can't be sure. Also, iOS 14 launched before iPhone 12 series, so it's hard to guess. There are a lot of things that changing with Big Sur. It can be said that it is one of the most important updates since Yosemite, which provided new UI close to iOS 7 style. So let's take a look at what macOS Big Sur brings us. Farewell to macOS X era. One of the important changes come up with macOS Big Sur is the new OS version. Apple dropped X from their operating system's name with Sierra, but they were still using 10 series OS versions since 2001. Now it is changing. Apple wants to emphasize that a lot of things are changing. Of course, one of the reasons are new Apple Silicon based Macs. So new processors, new macOS. New design. Apple changes macOS design completely with Big Sur. The design that came up with Yosemite goes after 6 years, and new, more iOS-like and redefined design comes. New modern app design. The new application design looks more clear and of course more close to iOS and iPadOS apps. Actually, the Photos and Mail app is really similar to iOS versions. New dock. The new dock is just new for Mac. The same dock design that has been used for iPad and iPhone comes to macOS. The new rounded dock is coming with smaller icons and bigger space between them. Control Center. One of the things that came from iOS is the Control Center. Now you can change your Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, AirDrop settings from this panel. Also, you can change brightness and sound too. Actually, it's looking good. Menu bar. Now the menu part is more transparent and can blend well with the background. Also, it can be hidden when not using, like dock. The icons in the menu bar also have bigger space between them. If Macs had a touch screen, we could easily press it by finger. Notification Center. New Notification Center design provides a single view that we can see widgets and notifications in the same tab. Notifications are grouped by apps, similar to iOS. Also, the new Notification Center is fully transparent. Maps. The Maps app has now cycling directions and electric vehicle routing functions. Also, there are new guides that shows the suggestion of places that can be visited or places to eat or shop. And users can also create their own guides. New Safari. Actually, we have the new Safari. The new Safari update has been given to Catalina and Mojave users before Big Sur release. But still we can talk about it. Now there is a customizable start page in Safari. You can set a custom background image for this page. And with new tab design, we can see the website's preview when we bring our mouse to that tab. Also, privacy report is one of the most important features of new Safari. It helps to prevent trackers and gives details about the visited websites. Messages. Since everything getting closer to iOS and iPadOS, messages also became more close to them. You can pin 9 of your conversations similar to iOS 14. They are showing in the top left side of messages screen. There is also new inline replies that help keeping the conversation more organized, which reminds me Slack, but it's an useful feature. Compatibility. In short, most Macs released after 2013 will receive this update. But Big Sur does not support the following devices that supported by Catalina: 2012 and early 2013 MacBook Pro, 2012 MacBook Air, 2012 and 2013 iMac, 2012 Mac Mini. When it's gonna be released? From the rumors going on, it can be said that there is good possibility for November with a new event for special MacBooks. But from the previous version's release history, since the developer beta 10 launched yesterday, the new macOS version can be released in a week. But it hurts to guess Apple's calendar in this year. So thank you very much. Please tell me what do you think about macOS Big Sur in comment section. I'll appreciate if you like this video and subscribe. Have a nice day. See you.